Hi, it's Janie. Welcome back to my channel. And today is going to be the third installment of my Las Vegas haul. And this particular video is going to be featuring the fashion house of Louis Vuitton. And I have a pretty long introduction that I want to do, and then I'll show you the products that I purchased while I was out in Vegas. I went to three different Louis Vuittons and had different experiences at each of those, and we'll get into that as I get further into the video. So without further ado, let me get into my introduction on Louis Vuitton and how I feel about Louis Vuitton. Okay, last year when we went to Vegas, I purchased my very first Louis Vuitton item at a pawn shop called Max Pawn, which is on Sahara Avenue in Las Vegas, and they specialize in a lot of designer goods, handbags, jewelry, that type thing. So I did buy my first Louis Vuitton on the pre-loved market. And I had always wanted a Louis Vuitton, especially the Speedy, and that was what I ended up purchasing. Excuse me while my eye is itching. So, as if you are familiar with me and my channel, this past year I've been on a makeup no buy, low buy, because I can drop some coin on makeup. And I decided this year that I was going to really watch my purchases on cosmetics, because I wanted to start, one, I wanted to pay off my credit cards, which I did, and two, I wanted to save money to be able to purchase a Louis Vuitton, which I did. So when my husband and I decided to go to Vegas at the beginning of August, it's when we decided to go, and we ended up going like toward the middle of August. Anyway, so between the time that we decided to go and the time that we actually went, I really started doing a lot of research on Louis Vuitton as a brand. I wanted to really do a research on the quality of the brand, customer service of the brand, and on the pre-loved market also. And doing so, I did find out and came to the conclusion of several things. One being that I decided I did not want to purchase a brand new handbag from Louis Vuitton. I wanted to stick with the pre-loved market for a handbag. But on the other hand, my small leather good items, I wanted to purchase those new at the Louis Vuitton instead of on the pre-loved market. So why would I want to purchase a handbag pre-loved versus brand new? Several reasons. One being that after doing extensive research and reading reviews, watching videos, I have come to the conclusion that the quality of the canvas products that Louis Vuitton produces, especially in the handbags, have declined in workmanship and quality over the last 8 to 10 years. So that is why I've opted not to purchase a brand new Louis Vuitton handbag. One of the reasons. So I decided I wanted to make sure my handbags were pre-loved and from 2009 or older, because it seems like in 2010 and thereafter, the quality of those pieces has changed. Not just a little bit, but dramatically. Secondly, why I want to purchase a handbag on the pre-loved market versus in store or off of the website is from the reviews that I have read and some of the horror stories that I've heard on YouTube about the customer service at Louis Vuitton, at the boutiques themselves. I read countless reviews of disgruntled people, customers that had purchased handbags, had an issue with them, go to return them and be told that they can't return it because it's been worn or it's been used or this, that, or the other. And one of the reviews that really hit home was a lady that in June was in Vegas and had purchased a handbag at one of those stores in Vegas, took it back to her hotel, waited till the following day, and after she slept on it, decided that she wanted the smaller size versus the size that she purchased. So she took it back to the store. It was less than 24 hours of purchasing it and was told that she had worn it, it had a watermark on it, and that she was not going to be able to exchange it. Now, she could have actually worn it, you know, that night. Who knows? We don't know the whole story. We just know from what she told in her review. But anyway, that review was pretty much consistent, though, with hundreds of other reviews that I looked at. So that's why I decided to go with the pre-loved on handbags. Another reason why I decided that I'm going to do the pre-loved on handbags is that Louis Vuitton has decided that they are going to not focus so much on their canvas pieces, but more so on their leather pieces. Of course, the rumor had been going around there for a while that they were going to discontinue the canvas pieces. That is not true. They are not discontinuing their canvas pieces, but what they are doing is they are going to start making those harder and harder to obtain at the boutiques. So basically, Louis Vuitton has decided that the marketplace, the consumer has oversaturated the canvas pieces out in the world, meaning that the canvas pieces are too obtainable for plain Janes, no pun intended, of people like myself that can walk in that not necessarily are prestige enough to be able to carry these pieces. So instead of increasing the price of the canvas, because the canvas pieces now are pretty much maxed out on prices. Louis Vuitton as a company knows this, and the consumer knows this. We know that if they were to increase the prices of these canvas pieces, they would not be purchased, and people would probably leave the fashion house of Louis Vuitton and go to other fashion houses such as Gucci, Hermes, Chanel, etc. So they have decided to make the canvas pieces pretty much online only. There's still pieces in the boutiques, but they're not going to be as many pieces in the boutiques that you can actually go into a boutique and say, I want to purchase a Neverfull, and they have it. The possibilities of being able to find one to where you can actually look at it in person and hold it before you purchase it is going to get harder and harder to do, because Louis Vuitton wants to focus more on their higher end products, their leather products, because right now Louis Vuitton is pretty much known as the starter fashion house into luxury. If you're wanting to get into luxury handbags or luxury goods, a lot of people start with Louis Vuitton because of the canvas price point. It is more obtainable for people to be able to come up with, say, $1,200 for a handbag versus $4,000 for a handbag, which would what would be at Chanel. Also, Louis Vuitton is wanting to be more like Hermes, where not just the everyday normal plain Janes can go in and purchase a Birkin at Hermes. I mean, you pretty much have to be you've got to be prestige enough to be able to be on the list to be able to even buy a Birkin or a Kelly. You're just not going to have somebody come in off the street and be able to purchase those. And that's kind of where Louis Vuitton is wanting to go to. They don't want to be known as the starter fashion house any longer. They want to be up there with Hermes. And I watched one video where back in 2000, I think, around that time frame, Louis Vuitton had started purchasing stock in Hermès. And they were purchasing so much stock that Hermès started getting really worried that Louis Vuitton was going to buy them out. So they went to court. There was a big battle and everything. Anyway, Louis Vuitton ended up signing an agreement that they would not purchase any stock in Hermès for 5 years. Well, that 5 years is almost up. So I think that's why they are really starting to go in the direction of they're going. They're not going to be discontinuing the canvas pieces because the canvas pieces, let's be real, the trunks is what made Louis Vuitton who Louis Vuitton is. But they're just wanting to be known as more of a more prestige brand than what they are. So, what I decided to do was when I went to Vegas, I knew that I was not going to be purchasing a handbag in any of the boutiques. I didn't even look at handbags in the boutiques. I wanted to focus in on getting some SLGs, small leather goods, and some bandeaus. That's what I wanted to look for, and that is kind of what I did. So, let's get started in showing you some of the pieces that I did purchase. The first Louis Vuitton that I went to was in the Bellagio. If you would have seen my other two videos, I think the one before this one's part two, where I talked about Chanel and Tiffany. That's where I had went to Chanel and Tiffany was in the Bellagio and had wonderful experiences in both those stores. So then I went across the little hall, the aisle, and went into Louis Vuitton. I walk in, there's nobody in there, there's no other customers, there's probably like five or six sales associates, and not one person greeted me, not one person asked if they could help me. Matter of fact, I was almost ran over by one of the sales associates trying to get to the other sales associate so that they could get together and start gossiping. So when it was in like two parts, you walk in and then you went through a little room. You could go this way, go to a room, or you go this way to go to a room. So I went over here and there was a little sales associate in there. And I think just because it was just the luck of the draw for her, she did ask me if I needed any help. And I was gonna say no, I'm just looking, but I thought no. I have certain items on my list that I want to look for while I'm in Vegas. I don't have a Louis Vuitton here in Oklahoma, so I don't get to go into a Louis Vuitton ever unless we're in Vegas. So I thought, no, I have money. I felt like, pretty woman, when she goes into the shops, I have money to spend in here. And I'm not going to back down. I have just as much right to demand service as anybody else. So I specifically asked her for an item that was on my list. She had it. She had to get it out of a drawer. It was not on display. And so I looked at it and I said, okay, yes, I want one of those. And then I asked her, there was no, is there anything else that you need? Or this is new, let me show you this, or anything like that. I had to specifically ask her for specific items before she engaged. So I asked her, for the second item that I was looking for, and she's like, yes, we have some. And so she opened up a drawer and let me look at those. And so I ended up purchasing two items in there. I would have purchased more, but I just wasn't satisfied with the service that I was getting. So I just purchased the two items and I will show those to you now. She did let me smell of the perfumes, but she did not offer to give me a sample of any of the perfumes. So anyway, okay, so let me show you the first item that I did purchase at that Louis Vuitton. And of course she wrapped it all up and put it in a sack, and then here is my receipt from that purchase. But anyway, I'm going to take this off. And this is actually something that I've been wanting for a while. Matter of fact, last year I was in Vegas. I asked about it in the Louis Vuitton that I was at. They didn't have it. So anyway, and I was going to order it online, and I ended up not. So anyway, it comes in the pouch, and it is this little guy right here. It is the Monogram round zippy coin purse, and it just opens like this. It is in the Monogram because this is the only canvas that it comes in. It doesn't come in the demi or bin. And of course, here's the textile card. I'm not going to show that with everything. And then the style number. I don't know if that's going to focus or not on that. Is that focusing? I don't think it is. Anyway, we're not going to worry about it because you can look at it online. But I did purchase this, and this was the first piece that I purchased, and that she had to pull out of the drawer because it wasn't on display. And that just kind of goes hand in hand with what I was saying earlier, where it's going to get harder and harder to find Monogram pieces or canvas pieces in the boutiques. Okay, the next item that I purchased there at that Louis Vuitton is in this little box here. And let's see if I can get it open. So still in a box with the little drawer. Then the little dust bag right here. And hopefully it's the right one, yeah. So this was the other product. The other pieces that I wanted to look for while I was in Vegas was a bandeau to put on my purse. And I wanted, there's two different ones I was looking for. I wanted this one because it has the pink in it. And then I wanted one that has red in it. And they didn't have one at that location with the red. But as you can see, it has the trunks. Do you believe? Is that what that is? Is the trunks? No. Okay. So that is what that little piece looks like there. And I'm going to use this to tie on my petite Noé, I do believe. So those were the two pieces that I purchased. So I'm going to go to this next Louis Vuitton. Okay, the next location was another Louis Vuitton. Now this one was the Louis Vuitton in Caesar's Palace. And I went in and was just kind of looking around. There's quite a few people in there. And just kind of moseying around and was looking at the perfumes. And the lady came to me and asked me, I need any help. I'm like, no, I'm just looking. She's like, well, did you know Louis Vuitton has perfumes? And she goes into the big spill about the perfumes, you know, how they're made, blah, blah, blah. What makes them so special? And she had asked me what kind of scents I like. And of course, you know, I say I like rose and florals. So she had me smell a couple different ones, told her which one I like. She's like, well, let me give you a sample of it. I'm like, okay. So she gets me out a sample. She goes, let me go get you a bag. So I figured she was just going to come back with a little pouch about like this big with my little sample in it. But no, she came back with this big sack. And in the sack was my little perfume sample. Isn't that funny? She gave me this big old Louis Vuitton sack for a little perfume sample. And this is the rose one. It calls Roses de Vence, I think. Rose de Vence. Anyway, so she gave me that, but I did end up making a purchase in there, but the one that they had, they only had one in stock, and it was messed up, and so she had to order one and then have it sent to my house. But anyway, it came in a box that looks like this, and she was so nice, offered me to get me a Diet Coke, wanted to know if there was anything else I could look at. She showed me some different things. Super, super nice. I mean, definitely a complete different experience than what I had at the one at the Bellagio where they just act like I was wasting their time. Anyway, here's my receipt for this item. And she treated me like a queen, and to be honest with you, I probably purchase the cheapest thing that you could probably purchase from Louis Vuitton ever, and that was a book. This is the Louis Vuitton The Spirit of Travel, and let me see if I can get it open. So this is the book that I purchased. Like I said, this is probably the least expensive thing that you could ever go into a Louis Vuitton store and purchase. What is, try this. Okay, there we go. I felt like I was like sitting on the ground. Anyway, this was $46, which I know some of you are like, well, that's a lot for a book like this. But it tells about the history of Louis Vuitton. There are actually several books about Louis Vuitton that I would like to get, but this was the only one that they had. And like I said, the actual one that they had in stock was messed up, so she had to order me one. But so anyway, I have my first Louis Vuitton book, and was very excited to get that. And like I said, you know, I only spent, you know, less than $50 in her store, but she was very, very kind and treated me with the utmost respect and very pleased with that purchase and with that experience. Okay, so the next items that I'm going to be talking to you about are some items that I purchased at the Louis Vuitton at the Fashion Show Mall. And my intention when I went to Vegas was to pretty much do all of my purchasing at the Louis Vuitton boutiques that were at the different casinos, like Caesars, Bellagio, and at the Crystals Shopping Mall, I think is what it was called. But I ended up purchasing quite a bit from the one at the Fashion Show Mall because they were so nice to me in there, not just the sales associate that was helping me, but everybody that was in there was so nice and just so warm and welcoming, and I couldn't have asked for a better experience than what I received. And the I was going to find the card for the sales associate that helped me there. And I ended up having the products that I purchased there shipped home instead of purchasing them there, so I didn't have to pay the tax. But anyway, her name was Misa Weiss. What? M-I-S-A-V-I-C-E? Client Advisor, I think is what that says. But anyway, that was at the Fashion Show Mall. Again, that's Misa, M-I-S-A, Weiss was her name. Like I said, she was so nice and so patient with me. She went above and beyond because she brought out so many different items for me to look at because I couldn't make up my mind. I was debating, and she was so patient. She didn't make me feel like I was being rushed or that I was wasting her time. She was just very, 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 very nice. So let's start with this product here. And they were all wrapped in the ribbon, but I've taken the ribbon off of some of them. But, and I was surprised. I didn't know if I would be able to purchase this item because I've heard some people say that you can, and I've heard some people say that you can't. It just depends on your sales associate. But I had told her, after I had picked out these other two items, that I wanted a luggage tag in the small. Well, she brings out a couple other luggage tags because she said they were out of the small, but she could order me a small. But she brought this one out, and I don't know, I just didn't want to wait for it to be ordered. And so I got a luggage tag, the larger size in the dark brown, that I'm going to put on my Damier bin. And I got it hot stamped. This is my first hot stamped item. And I got my first initial, a red heart, and my last initial R on there, which I just thought was so exciting because I haven't got to have anything hot stamped. So I had that hot stamped, and I'm going to use this as a bag charm on my Damier Bien piece. So I got that and didn't have any problems with, you know, purchasing it. And really, really excited. And that was able to get it hot stamped also. So I got that. And then this is the next item that I purchased. This is the one that took me the longest to decide on it. And I will show that to you here. And there's a story why. But anyway, I ended up getting this little guy here. Now this is from the men's side of the house. So I had it hot stamped also, but it's done in the silver with the heart, red heart in there. Because I guess the men's products have silver writing instead of the gold. But anyway, it is a card case. I was going to get a card case. And I don't know. I was thinking that the original card case was going to hold more cards. But after I got to looking at it, I realized it wasn't going to hold that many cards. And for the money, I wanted something that I could definitely put a lot of cards in. So this one, you can put a card here on the back. You open it up, you can put a card here, you can put a card here, you can put a card here, you can put cards behind in here, and then you have a slot here, and then you have all these slots right up here also. So this is what I ended up. Okay, I had to look up the name for this. This is actually called a pocket organizer, which makes a lot of sense since it has all these little pockets and places that you can put notes, receipts, bills, everything except for coins, but I have my little round coin purse for that. So I did get this instead of the card case. So very happy with that. And like I said, we had so many things out on the counter looking at it and trying to decide. She let me put my cards and everything to see how it looked. She let me put it in my purse to see how it looked in my purse. You know, she just super, super nice. So I have one more thing that I purchased from that location. And like I said earlier, I had been looking for a bingo in red. And I'll show you the one that I ended up picking. It's not the one that I had in mind, but this one they had just gotten in. So I picked it instead, and I don't even know what collection this is from, but I just thought it was really, really cute that it was with the monogram, and then it had the little trunks and the luggage, I guess, and it has the red. It also has some green and some yellow and some blue. So it has a lot of different colors, and then on the back is the same print on the back. The front and back is the same. So of course it's 100% silk. Has a little Louis Vuitton tag right there. And the item number M72395, I think. I'll put down here what the name of this is, because it didn't have a tag on it or anything that shows, but this wasn't the one that I had in mind that I was going to get, and they had the one in stock that I had in mind that had more red to it, but for whatever reason, I picked this one. I almost kind of wish I would have picked the other one because it had more red. But anyway, I got that one. So that is it for my Louis Vuitton purchases that I did at the boutiques and at the mall. And there's actually going to be a part four. Oh, my stars. I do have another 3 more pieces of Louis Vuitton that I want to share with you, but that in itself is a complete different story, and those pieces were from the pre-loved market, so I want to do that separate for from this one here, since these were all from the brand new boutiques, or from the boutiques. Anyway, thank you so much for joining me today. I hope that you have enjoyed, and I will make sure that I put little annotations down throughout the video showing what each of the items are, so that if you, once you purchase those, then you know what to ask for from your sales associate or from online. So anyway, thank you so much for joining me. I hope you enjoyed, and I'll talk to you soon.